Hello students, today we'll again continue with exercise number 12.1 from sum number 3. Sum number 3, 4, 5, these are all very very easy sums. Now question number 3, what it is saying? It is saying identify the numerical coefficient other than the constant term. Now we'll understand the meaning of this thing. First thing that you have to do, you can see that I have drawn one particular box, isn't it? And there are four columns are there. In the first column you have to write row, in the second column you have to write expression, third you have to write terms, and then finally you have to write numerical coefficient. So there are altogether I guess 10 sums are there under sum number 3. So I'm just showing 4. I guess 4 is enough. You will all understand how exactly it should be done. Now see, the first thing you have to do is that you have to write the under row, you have to write the number, which number you are doing. That is question number 1. The expression under question number 1, expression is given 5 minus 3t squared. Now you have to write the terms. How to write? First you will write the first term. This is the first term, and what is the second term? Minus 3t squared. If the third term is there, then you will write below it. Okay, this way you go. Now, because in the question it is saying other than the constant term, isn't it? So you will not write the constant term. I hope you remember what is a constant term. Constant term are those with which we do not have any variables. That is, no x, y, z, nothing is there. So this is a constant term, so we will not write the constant term. Other than constant term, every term you have to write it here. Okay, you will not write the constant term. Now, what is the numerical coefficient? That is, what is the number in this particular expression? That is minus 3. So this is your answer. Let's see question number 3. How many terms are there? 1, 2 and 3. So we'll write, there's no constant term, isn't it? So number 1, number first term is this, number second term is this, and third term is this. Now for this, what is the number? Do you find any number is there? If you do not see any number, that means 1 is there. So for this, numerical coefficient is 1. For this, numerical coefficient is 2. And for this, numerical coefficient is 3. Okay, so easy. Now we'll again write the terms again. How many terms are there? 1 and 2. So let's write the term first. Minus p square q square, and this is 7pq. So what is the numerical coefficient for this? Any number you can see? No, that means 1 is there. So minus 1, minus sign is there, be careful, minus 1. And 7pq. 7pq means, what is the numerical coefficient? Exactly student, it is 7. Now how many terms? Only 1. So we'll write only one term, that is r square. So what is the numerical coefficient out here? Very good, that is 3.14. so this is how exactly you have to do question number 3. Okay, so there are more sums. Remember that you have to do all the sums. I've just shown 4. That doesn't mean that you will do only 4. You will do all the sums. Even I will send you the solution also, don't worry. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, every sums you have to do, students. Okay, now, in the next session, I will explain you question number 4. It is also very, very easy.